So I'm going to continue what I'm doing. This means basically I'm gonna go forward and start adding details and whatnot to this character. So there's a few more like things to add, like greebles, just details. There's also like the entire section of like rubber. That's right now that's black. Black. Wow, that's red. It will be eventually black. So this is something that must be done as well. But yeah, so I'm just gonna go forward. I'm starting off right away. Just don't know how much time I'll have today, so might as well just like jump in right away. I hope everybody's doing okay. I'm gonna load a couple of alphas here. Give myself a couple of things to play with. I'm gonna come back. No, I'm gonna do this now. Just trying to get like a nice like elevation without like busting what I already have there. It's probably good. Okay, once again, I'm not in symmetry. Why am I forgetting that all the time? By the way, I'm hoping the sound is okay, if anybody can confirm this to me. Is it remesh really quickly on this thing just to equalize all the squares and everything? Let's remove the edge in the middle because it's kind of like not relaxing correctly with this. Sort. And put it back after. There we go. So this I'll already start dividing right away because it's kind of like more like of a detail I'm gonna be playing with it for sure. But I can start to be a little less like careful, I'd say. Like for the big shapes that we did on the element, that was really mandatory to to really be like fully like careful with everything so that it looks good. For these things, starting to get superficial a little bit, so there's a good part of it that we can just start to let go with. So using move brush with backface keeps the thickness of your object and you can push things in and out at your will after. Same thing here. Just like going around adding details. Just like placing like a strap object. We'll move it around after. Hiding it, splitting what I sit in, then undoing back until I get my. Until I get my subdivision level back. Hello, might I ask what program you're using? That's a ZBrush. Like Mar Pro 3D said. Oh yeah, I'm gonna stop the auto saves because okay, it's not aborting. I was too late. Because I got like three model open right now, because I might actually go and pick some stuff from another scene. I thought I was going to finish the rubber parts. I'm actually not even doing that. But sometimes that's an interesting thing. Sometimes I just prefer to let my mind flow and kind of like letting it figure out what it wants to do. Seeing like letting my eye just like guide my brush. Not trying to be poetic or anything, but just because okay, so here's, I guess, my point. At some point, you start to be kind of like comfortable with like your technique, and the workflow mostly. So things are not like as unknown as it can be when you start, right? So at some point, me, I just let it like, yeah, I just let my eye dictates to me what's the next thing that I should do. It's not about like following like a flow chart of like, oh, I need to do this and that and these steps. And it's fun when you can do that, actually. I'm realizing it maybe it is a bit boring because I don't talk, because I'm really in my head right now. So I'll try to talk. Just sorry if I don't. Just note if I don't talk, it's just because I'm in intense focus. There's a little trick that's cool. If you use clip circle and you keep the little plus sign in the middle of that circle inside of the mesh, and you use alt, it does something like that, which is not perfect. Sometimes you need to like planner it after to get rid of like the sides, but that cool little detail. Then I'll just need to adjust like here to have this like come in correctly. But it kind of helps to like make everything like connect together correctly. There's still like something that I need to do here though about that one. Let's just check. Cool, never heard of it before. It's a pretty important software in 3D modeling. Semi-Frodo, hello. Frosty HD, do you retopo your high-res models, or are most of them from for print? I feel like you're asking two questions right now. Do I retopo my models for high-res? I don't need to, even if I print. And yes, I do also print. Like this model, I'm thinking this model would be a model for print. Yeah, your work does all the talking. Thanks for sharing. Thanks, I appreciate that. Oh, Batter Glory. Thank you for your generosity to share your process. I'm learning so much so far. Cool. Awesome. That's great. Good to hear. They need a topological clip brush. Yes, I agree. Hello, Marco. Hello, Lobabi. Yeah, doing like this kind of like detail work is really fun, I find. Some people don't like it. I really like it. I really love doing like the pose and everything as well, right? Like there's just so much stuff that's cool. I love doing that. All right, let's add like a ledge here for like that new detail that I added. I think I'm gonna sculpt it, not an IMM, an alpha, I mean. Where's the something like that. Oops, it's not exactly where I want it to be. Buddy, I think it's gonna be better if I do it with the IMM after all. And then I'm gonna try to round it off with smoothing. Let's move brush to fix it. All right, let's smooth it out even rounder. Should be right like that. All right, so that's like an example of like how to like connect like elements together to make it look like it all belongs in this area. I'm gonna add one extra thing. think I'll fin try to finish like the mandibles a little bit more before moving forward, but anything else? Mickey Lart, finally caught your stream. Yeah, there you go. We'll see, Mart. UI question for you, Marco. Is there a way to have dynamic size cursor only with Z-modeler? I looked but couldn't find a way. No, I don't think so. I don't think so. Or at the very least, I wouldn't know how to do that. Sorry. I'm using my alpha to do like a major change in shape. That's one trick I recommend trying. Like, don't consider alpha as only like something you can try on the like for a small detail. Ooh, there's a little integrity problem with that mesh, huh? Good boy. I save my mesh here because I'm about to do something that I think might make it crash. Presque quand même, mais de rien. Hey everyone! Yeah, nobody will see. Should just do a close hole. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Fixed. Yeah, by the way, I'm playing Final Fantasy right now, the new one, Rebirth, Final Fantasy VII Rebirth, and yeah, it's pretty good. I'm feeling like there's a lot of like stuff that's really like fetch quest, maybe, but you know, I'm still doing them, so who am I to talk? I guess that they're not that boring if I'm actually doing them. Okay, that's enough work for a part that's going to be hidden. New. Sure. There we go. It's starting to look pretty like intricate. Looks cool. Are you using reference or sculpting from imagination? Mostly from imagination right now, but I've been repeating like this art direction for a little while now, so I mean I'm pretty used to it, let's say. I'll mask using a little bit of depth. I just want to mask the top part like this. Mask on mask, and I want to create a little elevation here. Ah, no, the masking of it is not satisfying. Let's revisit. Also, once I'm going to be finished with one part of the character, it's going to serve as like a style for the rest of the character, you know? So like those kind of like details and everything, they're going to be repeated over the character after. Sometimes I don't let myself do those kind of like details because there's part of me that believes it's like a bit superficial. And there's like this other part of me that's like, nah, man, that's super cool. Andres Pinilla, cheers to you too. I think I'm gonna take a break on this after all. I'm not gonna complete it like now. Or I will continue a little bit on it, but I won't force myself to complete it right now because I feel like for the front part, I'm gonna need to have a bit more of an idea where I'm going for the rest. Do another save. I'm having a lot of fun right now. I'm really busy with like some stuff right now, and I don't really have a lot of time to sculpt. So, man, just having a blast right now. There we go. Such a small detail, but I wanted to spend some time on it. I'm looking to earn back at minimum the license cost of ZBrush. Any tip on where to start and what to shoot for? I'm looking to earn back at minimum the license cost of ZBrush. Any tip on where to start and what to shoot for? Oh, I'm not sure I understand your question. Can you rephrase that? I feel like my H polish is acting a bit weird. Oh, okay. I had a bug with my brush, okay. I want to check something on my character for a second. Yeah, I think I'll have to. Those like alphas, like something pointed out on one of the streams, they look a little bit too much like nipples. I'm gonna have to work on that. I can pretty much like start doing it now, I guess. Castle to man. Good day to you. All right, so let's go on the mantis for a sec, see if we can't salvage a piece of her to make those probably be like these things here, I guess. Maybe these I can reuse as well. As I said earlier, I like to reuse pieces of my model as well. There's also those. Ooh, just got a little raid. Hey, everyone. Hello, hello, hello. Nice to see you. Nice to see you. Thanks, Bestie Art. Pretty cool. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. All right, let's start to... I do want the extrusions to be kind of like sticking out, though. As I say, I'm just not going to maybe put the centerpiece so small so it doesn't look like a nip. But, yeah, are we gonna take these one here or? Could maybe start with this. Hey, thanks for the sub as well. My God, Bestie Art. Too much generosity. Trim Dynamic, thanks for the comment. There's something not super clean about this IMN right there, so might as well just clean it before I start applying it everywhere. There you go, should be fine enough. Let's insert it in there. I don't like to reduce my details too much when I go and grab them from another model, because I want from like one model to the next that they have like the same look. And sometimes by reducing the scales you kind of like lose a bit of that look, but we're gonna take a chance with this one. Oops. Right. I guess that's gonna be it. Bestie art, your works are amazing, always supporting. Yeah, I appreciate that. I appreciate this. Thank you. Maybe a bit sharper than that. Okay, this I probably should be doing an IMM of this piece. I'm going to like reuse it everywhere. So let's give it some colors. Yeah, I think just that should be fine. Even wondering if let's try that. Let's do an IMM of this. Oop, it's not symmetrical. Now it is. So let's just put that back straight. Or as straight as it can. I know like this one is like starting to get a little bit like narrow. I've just reused it so like many times and I kind of like weren't super delicate with it. So it's kind of like skewed now and stuff. Well, as long as it looks somewhat circle. we'll be fine. All right, let's create an IMM for that. Create insert mesh brush, new. Oh wait, it's not dragging the poly paint with it? I was kind of sure that it was. Oh well. I'll still save it. Okay, so that's the right depth. I think it's also the right size. Okay, yeah. So like from now on, anytime I have a plug like this, I can just reuse this material. It's just every time I have to apply the poly paint though, that's the only thing that sucks. Okay, one or two things I'm going to do real quick that I'm seeing. I don't really like that how it's stretching the eye hole. I'm trying to find like the like a restriction in the depth here that's going to be satisfying. I'm thinking maybe I'll go restricted by polygon instead, by polygroup, I mean. Okay, and now I'll see if I can flatten this and make it look better because it's a bit wonky right now. First of all, we're gonna smooth it out. This. We're gonna mask it so it doesn't smooth too much. Let's try this and see if it works. I think we can work with that. Cool. All right. I can dig that. Well, almost. I just have to fix. It's good. Yeah, I'm starting to feel my focus kind of like going away, so I think I'm going to have to change what I'm working, the type of thing I'm working on. So maybe let's go and fix those rubbery part for now. But I'm pretty happy with like what we've done. Yeah, so far I'm pretty happy with the results of this. Oh yeah, by the way, for those who were there in my past streams, I'm happy to announce that my renovation of the house are soon over. This freaking nightmare of going through all of this. Almost done. Which means I won't have that tarp at the back much longer. Not a character artist, but your Elden Frog series thought me enough to make one for a client. They were pleased, so thanks. Oh, cool. Awesome. I'm really happy to hear that. Carpe diem art. Was the renovation supposed to take this long? No, it was supposed to take 3 months. The first company fucked me over right before they started, and it actually like ended up taking me another like 4 months to find another company. And then when I started with this other company, they also said 3 months, and it ended up being 1 year. So yeah, I mean like I'm. There's so much like I can't really like bash them also because like at the same time it's not like their fault really. There was some renovation on my street at the same time as I was supposed to have the renovation start. So like it's like some city renovation I mean on my street, and it kind of like pushed back like everything. Yeah, like I it's not really like their fault, but I mean it's still freaking frustrating. Like if you ever like do renovation, like be ready to have like 1,000 things that like you cannot foresee and that's gonna be like in your way and fuck with you and like and it's never going to be the price that you think that it is. There's always going to be like it's always gonna cost more because of this or that or whatever, you know? So yeah, I'm just so ha like I feel like I'm waking up from a from like a bad dream now. I mean, there's a lot of work ahead of us, right? Still, but a lot of like the bad part of it is done pretty much like by the end of this week. Chicky, hello. Hey there. Hey, Chibi. Hi there. So nice to come upon your stream. Cool armor sculpt. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. So, Carpe Diem, I will miss that tarp in the background. Promise to bring it back every now and then. Yes, on every anniversary of that stream, I'm gonna bring the tarp back. don't have much expectations, please. A reminder that I use them standard often to kind of like find my edges, and then I'll just like smooth it out. I find it's a good way to kind of like show ZBrush like what's really like the angle basically, and then like brushes like H polished are gonna follow better afterwards. I think I can relate. In a former condo, we had a tarp across our living room for 7 months because of structure deterioration and leaks. Boy, that was a stressful time. Well, yes, I think it's especially stressful for you because, like, also this was about like the deterioration of your house, right? So like this really like is really a stressful It's a really a stressful thing to go through. Luckily, I didn't have this stress because me was not about like it's about expanding like my house, so it's not about the deterioration. So there's like this. There's not like that stress of like, oh, what's gonna happen, like with my house, basically. Yeah. Well, I made those. Renovation because I actually had problems in the basement, but I decided to turn it into like augmenting the quality of life of my apartment basically by expanding. Yeah, no, for sure it's still stressful. I mean, it's such like a big thing, and it's happening in your face, and you see it, and you live in it. So, no, of course, any kind of like that kind of stuff is stressful for sure. much time do we have still? 10 minutes. 10 minutes. Yep. I think it's worth saying that, of course, like this kind of like what I'm doing, like working on the head of a character, it's pretty time consuming. I mean, I'm guessing like the high poly and everything like that is like a work of maybe like a good solid 2 days, three, maybe four even. But like working on it just like 2 hours per week, like you don't get like super far, right? So yeah, we're gonna spend a few streams on the head, right? But you know, it's gonna be worth it in the end, so it's all good. But no, it's worth to remind people to be patient. Not like if not that people are impatient. I guess I'm just saying, be ready to see me work on that subject for a little while. I guess I wish it was faster. Maybe I'm projecting. Let me try something. Oh, actually, I need to put the stream on pause for a sec. Okay, I'm back. I'm back. I actually was receiving the call I was waiting for. So you know, I'm just going to leave like this here is gonna serve as a reminder of like where I'm going. But yeah, I mean, look, we added a couple of like detail, worked on the structure of this, a little bit of design, those things here. So yeah, we did a bit of work. It's time consuming, but it is what it is. But it's fun, but it's fun. It's fun. Let's go and see if we can raid someone. Yeah. Have you thought of giving this guy something that looks like the hairs on some spiders? Not really, because it will be hard to make it for print. HP looks clean. Thank you. That's one of my prerogative. All right. So, yeah, like I said, that's pretty much it for today. I hope that this was fun for everyone. Yeah, next week I'll continue on the high res and everything. At some point we'll have a clean head and everything. Does it look good? It's gonna look good. Yeah, so far thanks for sticking around. Like I said, I know it's a long process, but happy to have people working alongside me, asking the questions and everything. So, yep, let's do that. Let's go raid someone. I wish you all a good week. So take care of yourselves.